All right, so Charles, what do you think would be some reasonable resources to try to manage in a learning algorithm?
Okay, well, I was thinking of three, because three is my favorite number. Two of them are what you already have written up there, time and space. After all, at the end of the day, it's still an algorithm, and we need to be able to analyze algorithms in terms of time and space.
That's right. So if, in particular, if we have a learning algorithm and they do more or less the same things, but one runs in n squared time and one runs in exponential time, we'd really like to have the one that runs in the shorter amount of time. Or in particular, if we define a learning problem and we say, well, we can do this computation, but it's NP hard, then maybe that's a problematic way of defining the problem. So yeah, time definitely matters, space for the same reason. And those are the same things that happen or that are relevant in regular algorithms. What about anything specific to the machine learning setting?
Okay, so that was my third one. So the only thing that matters in machine learning, or the most important thing in machine learning, is data. So I would think that another resource that we care about is the data, and in particular, the set of training samples that we have.
Yeah, so I like the word samples, though, you know, data is probably a pretty good thing to stick in there as well. Or examples. Those should all be okay. Yes, indeed. Yeah, we want to know, can we learn well with a small amount of samples? In particular, if our learning algorithm works great in terms of time and space, but in order to run it, you actually have to give examples of every possible input, then that's not going to be a very useful algorithm. So the fewer samples that it can use, the more that it's generalizing effectively and the better it is at learning.
Well, that makes sense.